China has upped the ante amid tensions with India and has claimed the whole of Galwan Valley. In an official statement released around midnight by the embassy in New Delhi, China claimed that the Indian forces violated the June 6th understanding by crossing LAC and violently attacking Chinese soldiers. China has for the first time since the 1950s claimed sovereignty over the Galwan Valley. While India asked Beijing to not make untenable claims, Beijing further claimed in a statement that its border troops had been patrolling this region for many years.
Addressing leaders of all political parties present at the all-party meeting, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said neither has China intruded into our border nor has any Indian post been taken over by them. Prime Minister said 20 of our Jawans were martyred, but those who dared Bharat Mata were also taught an apt lesson. He reiterated that whether it is deployment, action, counteraction by air, land or sea, our armed forces will do whatever it takes to protect our country. PM said India possesses the capability that no one can even eye an inch of our land. PM said our Jawans now stop and warn those who were till now never questioned or stopped. He added that to protect our borders, the government has given importance to infrastructure development. The requirements of our armed forces, be it fighter planes, advanced helicopters, missile defense systems, everything is being given priority.
न वहां कोई हमारी सीमा में घुस आया है, न ही कोई घुसा हुआ है, न ही हमारी कोई पोस्ट किसी दूसरे के कब्जे में है. लद्दाख में हमारे 20 जाबाज शहीद हुए, लेकिन जिन्होंने भारत माता की तरफ आंख उठाकर देखा था, उन्हें वो सबक सिखा कर गए.
Delhi on Friday reported its highest single-day spike of 3,137 new coronavirus cases, which took the capital COVID count past the 50,000 mark. Delhi now has a total of 53,116 coronavirus cases, out of which 27,512 are active. With the addition of 66, the death count has reached 2,035. Delhi has been reporting over 2,000 daily cases for several days. This is the first time that the tally has crossed 3,000.
The Delhi Disaster Management Authority, headed by Delhi LG Anil Baijal, has issued fresh guidelines regarding the home quarantine and isolation of COVID-19 patients in the national capital. In an order, state authorities were told to ensure that people testing positive for COVID-19 undergo a 5-day institutional quarantine instead of home quarantine, even if they are asymptomatic or have mild symptoms. It added that mandatory physical verification of each home isolation case has to be carried out by surveillance officers assigned. Patients who do not require hospitalization will be allowed to go home after 5 days of mandatory institutional quarantine. Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal had earlier said people with mild or no symptoms of the virus can recuperate at home to avoid additional burden on the city's already overwhelmed healthcare infrastructure.
Delhi Health Minister Satyendra Jain, who had earlier tested positive for COVID-19, has been put on oxygen support after his lung infection increased. The Delhi Health Minister has developed pneumonia and is facing breathing difficulties. He is being constantly monitored as per doctors. Jain has been shifted to Max Hospital in Saket and is likely to be given plasma therapy. Home Minister Amit Shah tweeted, praying for a speedy recovery.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi will launch a massive rural public works scheme, the Garib Kalyan Rozgar Abhiyan, today to create jobs for millions of migrant workers who returned home during the coronavirus pandemic. The 50,000 rupees scheme aims to provide 125 days of work in rural areas by starting various infrastructure projects across 116 districts in 6 states. The program will cover 116 districts across Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Jharkhand and Odisha. All these districts have received more than 25,000 migrant workers during the lockdown.
The World Health Organization has warned of a new and dangerous phase of the coronavirus pandemic, with people tiring of lockdowns despite the disease's accelerating spread. The virus, which has now killed more than 4.5 lakh people and infected close to 85 lakh worldwide, is surging in the Americas and parts of Asia, even as Europe starts to ease restrictive measures. Lockdowns imposed to halt the spread of the disease have caused crippling economic damage, but the WHO said that the pandemic still posed a major threat.
The Drug Controller General of India, or the DCGI, has approved favipiravir, an antiviral drug, for restricted use in COVID-19 patients. The regulator says the drug can be used only in case of emergency and family consent is mandatory, adding that the course duration is just 14 days. Pharma giant Glenmark is currently conducting trials using the drug and will continue to do so. The DCGI nod came after good results in the pharma company's trials. The DCGI said surveillance is needed for the first 100 patients. Favipiravir is used for influenza around the globe. Russia, China, and Japan are already using the drug for COVID-19 patients.
You may be aware of fever and coughing as dominant symptoms of COVID-19, but researchers have found another symptom that could be an alert for getting tested. Researchers say that pink eye or conjunctivitis and keratoconjunctivitis can also be primary symptoms of the new coronavirus. The study cites a case of a 29-year-old woman who came to a hospital with a severe case of pink eye and minimal respiratory symptoms and no fever, who later tested positive for COVID-19. Published in the Canadian Journal of Ophthalmology, the team said studies at the onset of the pandemic too identified conjunctivitis as a secondary symptom in about 10 to 15% of virus cases.
With most sporting events being affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, number one ranked women's all-rounder Elise Perry feels that the Women's World Cup in early 2021 could be a bit irrelevant given the forced restrictions.
I think, you know, with the whole situation, it's really hard to kind of have a gut feel on where things might go, because I think the whole landscape changes so quickly at the moment. And I guess in some ways, in the scheme of things, a World Cup seems a little bit irrelevant given everything else that's gone on. But at the same time, yeah, I mean, I guess everyone's probably just going to prepare like it's going to happen.
The Women's World Cup is currently scheduled to be played from February 6th to March 7th.
Reliance Industries' market capitalization crossed the 11 lakh crore mark on Friday after its stock surged 8% during the day. The scrips of RIL hit a fresh record high of 1,788.60 rupees a piece to touch a market cap of over 11.30 lakh crore rupees on the BSE. The stock has been doubled from its March low of 867.82 rupees. Flipkart-owned online fashion and lifestyle store Myntra has hired 5,000 employees across its supply chains and customer care departments as it kicks off the 12th edition of its end-of-reason sale from the 19th to the 22nd June. The coronavirus pandemic has changed the dynamics of shopping by pushing consumers towards online portals. As a result, Myntra expects about 30 lakh people to shop on its platform during the sale.
After actor Sushant Singh Rajput's untimely death on June 14th, Instagram has now memorialized the late actor's account on the social media platform. The photo-sharing application changed Sushant Singh Rajput's account settings to memorialized in honor of his memory by adding the word remembering in his profile bio. As per ANI, once Instagram memorializes an account, nobody is allowed to log in to the account of the deceased person's profile, and now the account would remain just as the late actor left it.